Hi everyone, I'm happy to be here again with you, and I want to share something that is very close to my heart. It's about our relationship with food. You know, we talk about all this all the time. We are what we eat, right? Everybody says that a lot. We are what we eat, but what's more important is we eat who we are. You see the difference? So we eat who we are, and I'm going to expand on that a little bit more. If you see a little baby who eats food, you know, you will see that baby eats food only when they are hungry, right? They eat food when they're really, really hungry. And no matter if they're not hungry, no matter how much food you will force onto them, they will not eat. And they will eat only as much they can potentially take in and digest. So there is no greed for additional food. So little baby is really in tune with their hunger, is in tune with their thirst, and will eat only when it's hungry, and it's not gonna eat more than what is required. And therefore, eating as an experience, if you see a child eating food, especially when they're enjoying the food, you can see it's a spiritual journey, because our relationship with food defines our relationship with ourselves. Okay, our relationship with food defines our relationship with ourselves. So when a child eats food, there is no judgment around food. No, the child is not thinking, oh, this is bad, this is unhealthy, this is sugar, this is fat, this is proteins, this is carbohydrate. There is no, sorry about that, my camera just fell down. So the child is not thinking about whether this is bad, good. So there is no sense of judgment around food. Food is just eaten because it's a source of energy. It is used as a source of nourishment for the mind, body, and soul. Therefore, when we eat, adults, when we eat our food, there is a lot of judgment around food. This is, you know, this is bad for us, this is good. Now, this judgment around food also leads to a sense of deprivation, right? So, for example, if you say, okay, no sugar ever in my life, no carbohydrates ever in my life, no this, no that. So there is a lot of judgment around that food, rather than being in love and being in, you know, in relationship with food, in harmonious relationship with this, judgment is what leads to deprivation. Okay. And when we deprive ourselves, and when A, there is judgment, and second, when we deprive ourselves with the food that we love, there is more craving for that thing, right? The more we say, okay, I don't want to do that, the universe does not listen, I do not. It only listens to I want, okay? So if every time you say, I do not want this in my life, instead of saying, I do not want that, say what you want in your life. So the moment we say, I don't want to eat sugar, I do not want to eat carbohydrates, I do not want to eat junk food, whenever we are saying that, the universe does not hear, I do not want, it only hears, I want. So similarly, that's the message you're sending to yourself. So A, there is a judgment. Second, when there is a judgment, there is a sense of deprivation. Okay, when there is a sense of deprivation, that's when people tend to consume the same amount of food. Say, for example, if I like chocolate, right? Now, if I have judgment around chocolate, the chocolate is bad for me and I'm not going to eat it, the likelihood is, if I have not eaten it, then there is a sense of deprivation. Now, this sense of deprivation leads to cravings. Okay? So instead of, I love my chocolate, I want to have a piece of chocolate and I want to enjoy it and I want to, you know, enjoy the whole experience of consuming that chocolate. I want to feel the chocolate. I want to feel the energy rush. I'm absolutely present with that experience of consuming the chocolate. When I have, and there is no judgment, there is no craving. So I will probably stop at a small piece of chocolate or a small piece of a biscuit or a small, you know, one or two chips, and I will stop at that. We're living in a society when there is so much judgment around food that we are constantly depriving ourselves and therefore starving ourselves. And when we are starving ourselves, we have more and more and more craving. So this is the cycle of craving, right? So we've got to break the cycle of craving. And the only way to do that is to have a harmonious relationship with food. The other thing is, like I said, a child eats only when they're hungry, okay? So we talked about we are what we eat. What's more importantly is we eat who we are, Okay, what does that really mean? We eat who we are. So if we are sad, if we are lonely, if we are depressed, if we are angry, the food that we attract and we are attracted to is likely something that is not healthy for us. Okay, so if you see a lot of people when they're lonely, when they're bored, you know, that's where they will go out for that, you know, mug of beer or the packet of chips or the box of mithai or any kind of sweet and savory stuff. So when there is a loss of love in our life, when there is loss of love in any form, okay, whether that's love from other people, but more importantly, our love for ourselves. When we don't love ourselves for who we are and what we stand for, there is again, this leads to more craving, and food becomes your ally and your support ecosystem. So rather than creating your own internal support ecosystem, being in love with food, the food becomes an ally. So therefore, our relationship with food is really spiritual. Our relationship with food is really spiritual. If we are connected with our mind, our body, and our spirituality, we will eat healthy food. We would eat things that are nourishing. And even if there are things that are so-called not that healthy or fall in that category, we don't have judgment around that. We still enjoy the experience of consuming that food without having a sense of deprivation, right? So if you've seen yourself or somebody who, you know, looks at food as a source of ally, or somebody, and a lot of people, as I've coached so many people around the globe, the underlying root cause for even weight gain is always somewhere else. It's always somewhere else. There's always some stress, agony, loss of love, loneliness, boredom, loss of sense of direction in life. And that is what, you know, motivates them towards making those choices in life, right? So the thing is, how do we really practice mindful eating? Okay, how do we really practice mindful eating? The best way to practice mindful eating is to, when you're actually sitting with the plate of food, to be completely present. To be completely present. Not watching television, not doing any other thing or working on your mobile or doing anything. Really being present in the food. Look at your food. Look at how your senses are responding to food. Take time to taste the food. See how it feels like. Does it feel sweet, savory, salty, you know, bitter? What does the food really taste like? An Indian thali is a combination of all of these tastes and senses. So all the colors, the taste. So be present with your senses and see how those respond to food. And when you're eating, it's also not important what you eat. What's also important is who you eat with, right? When you eat, who you eat with, and what you eat, all of those things are important. So when you're sitting down for dinner, lunch, or breakfast, make sure you are an embodiment of positivity. So if you are an embodiment of positivity and you have created a positive environment in your home and office, that affects the quality of energy that is produced from the food that you're eating. So make sure you are completely present. That's how you say, I am mindful about my eating. You're also eating only as much as you're hungry. Okay, you're not, that's when you, sometimes we're just sitting there and watching TV and we're just eating. We have no idea how much we have eaten. We're just looking at our phone, we're looking at our Facebook, you know, we're looking at our WhatsApp, whatever we are doing, we're not really present. So we're not really chewing that food, we're not really being mindful of our food, and we land up probably eating maybe 1/3 more than the body actually requires, maybe twice as much. So it's very important to be mindful, to be present with your food, have all your sensory organs connected with the food, experience the food, enjoy the food, cherish the food, and make sure you're in company when you're eating food. The whole idea of family sitting down for dinner and lunches is beautiful because you are actually sitting in a community and there is sharing of food. right? There is a communal feeling about sharing of food, and that is a blessing to have in our life today, especially more now than we are living nuclear relationships, right? In nuclear families. So really have that relationship with food. So food does not have to be our enemy, okay? With this whole race to look a particular way, to be a particular way, be a model figure or have six packs, you know, we have created an obsession in our society. We really have created an obsession in our society with that we have to look X to be happy, you know, rather than focusing inward and enjoying our food and embracing movement that is joyful. We are really, you know, more focused on what other people think of me and how I should look like, or what my expectation is that I should look like. So when we move beyond just the physical attributes and have a deeper connection with ourselves, we will be healthier in mind, body, and spirit. Therefore, our relationship with our food is spiritual. Our relationship with our food tells us a lot about who we are and what we are doing in our life. So the likelihood of people that you see happy, blissful, stress-free, you know, enjoying even food, yet being healthy and vibrant energy and being well, you know, living the life of their dream, they usually have a spiritual connection with food. They're very connected. They understand the food that they eat nourishes them emotionally, spiritually, in every sense of the being. So let's stop this fixation. No deprivation, no starvation. Connect with yourself, being mindful of yourself, and really look at the food as a source of nourishment. Do not look at it as a punishment, right? Then we're living in a society where whenever we eat, even if I eat half a samosa or anybody eats a half a samosa, it's like, you know, why did you do that? So let food be a source of nourishment, of spiritual upliftment, and also contribute to your overall health, mind, body, and well-being. So try and practice and be more mindful of your eating, and tell me, how does that feel? Does it feel any different to you? Do you feel better? Do you feel healthier? And do you feel well? So take care. Take care, and I will see you again tomorrow. Ciao for now.